Welcome back, friends. Now the second part of the combustion calculation. Now second part is all about the determination of flue gases, that is the product obtained by combustion of the fuel. Whatever the product gases are obtained, we have to do the calculations of it. For that we have to consider the excess of air which is supplied. So here in this numerical, 45% of excess air is supplied. So we have to find out accordingly what is the actual air which is supplied for combustion. So in the first part of the numerical, we have calculated the theoretical air required. So here we have to find out the actual air using the theoretical air. So here it is very important that this theoretical air is the amount in kilomole for 100 kg of fuel. It is not which is determined for 1 kg or according to question. It is the very first answer which we have determined for the theoretical air from the calculated amount of oxygen. So for actual air, multiply the theoretical air which is calculated by the 100 plus percent excess divided by the 100. That is, this ratio is the excess of the air which is used. So according to as we have 45, so the ratio will become 145 divided by 100. So according to the given excess air, you have to add that excess quantity here, add in 100 and divide by 100, you will get that ratio, and multiply that ratio with the theoretical air, you will get the amount of actual air. So actual air is equal to theoretical air multiplied by 100 plus excess air upon 100, and this multiplication will give you the actual air. The answer is in, again in the kilomoles. So the important factor is you have to take the theoretical air for 100 kg, not for 1. So you will get the actual air. By using this actual air, now we have to find out the other quantities. The product of combustion we have already calculated in the very first table. That is, in the first table, along with the oxygen, we have also calculated the combustion product. As here we can see, along with the oxygen which is determined in the very first table, we have also determined the product, that is flue gas. So the carbon dioxide, SO2, water, these are the product obtained by the combustion, that is by the oxidation you get the combustion product. But along with this combustion product, nitrogen also obtained as a one of the combustion product, because nitrogen do not react with oxygen and present as it is in the air. So nitrogen also you are required to be calculated, and oxygen is not actually calculated from the given air or theoretical air, but oxygen will only present if the excess of air is there. For example, if there is no excess air is provided, then no oxygen will be present in the product. So if the excess air will be there, then and then only the oxygen will be present in the product, because oxygen is utilized in the combustion. So if the excess air is given, then only you will be obtaining oxygen in the product, that is in flue gas. So carbon dioxide, SO2 and water we have determined in the first table only, and this will be used in the flue gases calculation. It is very important that whenever in the numerical the word dry product is mentioned, then in that case you are not required to use this water value. That is, as the question is asked for dry product, don't consider the water. If suppose the question is for volumetric composition of product, then that case you have to consider H2O. Even in the case of wet product, you have to consider the water amount. But if the word is dry, don't consider this water in the calculation. So back to the calculation. Here now we have to calculate the total nitrogen. Total nitrogen, it is the quantity obtained both from the fuel and from the actual air supply. As your fuel, if it contain any nitrogen, it will be available in the product, and whatever the nitrogen present in the actual air, that is also available as the product of combustion, that is flue gas. So to calculate the nitrogen from actual air, multiply the actual air by the ratio 79 by 100, This is came from as the oxygen is 21%, remaining is considered as the nitrogen. So multiply by 79 by 100, and then you will get the answer of the nitrogen present in actual air. So add both these quantity, you will get the total amount of nitrogen which is present in the flue gases. Now for oxygen, it is very important to find out the excess of air, because oxygen is only available in the excess of air. So excess of air can be calculated easily by subtracting the amount of theoretical air from the actual air. So subtract this amount of theoretical air from actual air, you will get the excess of air, which is again in flue mode. And now you have to find out that from the excess air, how much oxygen is there. So for that, you have to use the exactly opposite formula which you are using the very first calculation. So excess of air multiplied by 21 by 100. It is very important here, don't confuse between 100 by 21 and 21 by 100. In case of the previous first part, when you have to calculate air, the 100 was in numerator and 21 was in the denominator, because you have to find the air. Now here you have to find the oxygen. Therefore 21 is in the numerator and 100 is at the denominator. So by multiplying by this factor, you will get the answer of the oxygen present in the excess of air. So this is the excess of air, multiplied by 21 by 100, you will get the amount of oxygen present in the excess of air. Now we have to use all these calculations for our percent composition of the flue gases. So for this, it is very simple, that is, individual component, write down all the individual products present in the flue gases. It is CO2, SO2, H2O, nitrogen and oxygen. So these are the products obtained. As the question is for the dry product, therefore H2 is not considered in the calculation. Now how to calculate the percent composition. For percent composition, individual component, that is whatever individual component percentage you have to take, it is this, that is required to be taken in the numerator, and you have to add all this the component and find out the total. This total is required to be mentioned in the denominator, and as you are required to find out the percentage, it is important to multiply by 100. So numerator is the given component, denominator is the total, and multiply by 100, you will get the percentage of the individual component. And the calculation of this percent composition of the product, you use the remaining 4 marks, and it is 8 marks can be achieved easily. Now for the example, if suppose you are asked for the weight percent composition, here you have calculated the volumetric percent composition, but if suppose you are asked for weight percentage, that is, you are supposed to find out the weight of the product. In that case, what you have to do? You have to find out the weight of the given component. This is we have already calculated. Now we have to just convert this into the weight. Now here I have considered that, for example, weight product conversion is asked. Then in this case, when the weight products are asked, you are supposed to take the water in consideration. That is 2.5, that is the amount of water obtained, that is also required to be considered in the adding all these components. So here what we have done, we have converted the individual component into their weight. So how it is converted? It is converted by multiplying the individual component by their molecular weight. For example, carbon dioxide 44, SO2 64, water 18, nitrogen 28, oxygen 30. So by multiplying the individual component by their molecular weight, you get the weight of all the components. Add all this, then the same similar formula, it is the numerator of the individual component divided by the total, and multiply by 100, you will get the weight percent composition of the given flue gases. So here it is the calculation for weight percentage. Is weight percentage, that's why you have to convert the given kilomole into weight, and as it is the weight, that is, you are required to find out the water, therefore here you have to consider the water. So in case, for example, you are also required to find the air fuel gases. So this is a next type of numerical where this may also ask in the same 8-mark question that find out the air fuel ratio. In that case, for solid and liquid fuel, the formula is as we are considering the weight of fuel, therefore you have to consider the weight of the actual air divided by the weight of the fuel. In the very beginning of the numerical itself, you have considered that 100 kg of fuel is used. Therefore, 100 kg, therefore, you are considering weight. Now, we have to find out the weight of actual air. So, actual air weight can be determined by multiplying the actual air by 28.95. This is nothing but the average molecular weight of air. So, this will convert the given kilomoles of actual air into the weight of actual air. So, this is the answer for weight of the air divided by the weight of the fuel, and in this way you are going to get the air fuel ratio for the solid or liquid fuel. The second case which we are going to discuss in the second video, it may be the same question, that is air fuel ratio you have to determine for a gaseous fuel. In that case the ratio is very simple, that is you are only required to find out the volume of actual air and the volume of fuel. This is the only ratio you have to consider where there is no requirement of any multiplication, because volume of the actual air is already your determined, that is kilomoles of the actual air is equal to volume of the actual air, and in consideration of volume of the fuel it is 100 only. So no required of any multiplication, just take the ratio of this two, it will give you the air fuel ratio. So thank you for watching the video. And if you are having any queries or further doubts in this numerical solving, feel free to contact me. Thank you.